Hey, what's up Blender users, I'm Jonathan, and in today's video, I wanted to continue my little terrain series I uploaded a few months ago. I started showing different methods on how to create and erode height maps for free, and then texture them in Quixel Mixer just so we can import them back into Blender. But there are actually better and faster methods of creating digital landscapes. To show you this, I'll use Unreal Engine 4. A real-time game engine which is being used in cinema for digital set extensions and more. For a long time, I thought that real-time engines are inferior to offline renderers because they use much more powerful and expensive algorithms to calculate lighting and more. But this really isn't the case anymore. In addition to that, game engines like UE4 offer a lot of improvements that make it a lot easier to work with terrain. So let me show you how we can get from this to this. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said, let's get straight into the video. For a terrain like the one you just saw, we need a software to create a height map. And I'll be using TerraSculptor because it is free and has a lot of great features for us to use. So let's click on new project and I'll use a size of 1k. And just like this, we have our gray plane, to which we can now start adding noise and different modifiers like erosion and displacement. So let's navigate to the noise map menu and choose gradient. Under presets, I like picking the rough mountains one and then scale them down a little bit. And just like this, we already have believable terrain. We can further improve the look of our terrain by playing with these options down here. But I for myself enjoy this landscape right here, so I'll just click on OK. Now we can either go under Modify or Transform to, for example, displace our terrain. But I will head right over to Erosion, select Rain, and click on this 1/2 button. For me, it always gives believable results. And now we can basically just export this terrain as a height map. There is, of course, a lot more you can do, but for the sake of this video, I will leave it at this. To export this terrain in a way we can use it in Unreal Engine, just go to File, Export Terrain, give it a name, and then choose the file type RAW. Once you click on Save, you can use these values. Both the conversion type and byte order are default values, but for the data type, I chose 16-bit short unsigned. And just click OK. As already mentioned, I want to use this height map we just created in Unreal Engine, because there are just a lot of things that work a lot better in UE4 than in Blender. So once you have installed Unreal Engine over the Epic Games Launcher, we can click on Launch. Let's create a new project for this video. You can now decide if you want this to be a game or for film and television. Personally, I will use the game preset. Click on Next and then choose the third person template. This gives us a simple character which we can use to walk around on our terrain. In the next tab, I'll use the starter content and leave everything on default. And now you can also give your project a name. Once your project has loaded, let's instantly go to File, New Level, choose the default one and save it. Great. If we click on Play, you can see that we have a simple character controller with which we can run around. I do not want the simple floor to run around, but a whole landscape. So let's select it and delete it. Let's next just search for the landscape object and drag it into our scene. We can zero out the location and choose Import from File and navigate to our height map we just created. Our terrain is now visualized as a wireframe mesh, and we can manipulate, for example, the height using the Z scale slider. And I quite like how it is looking right now, so I will click on Import. Awesome, and now our terrain is in our scene. And you can already see that something has changed, because right now, after importing our terrain, we are in the sculpt mode. This is a huge difference to Blender, because we can actually manipulate the terrain which is just based on a height map. In Blender, this wouldn't really be possible, because to import a terrain at that resolution, the viewport would start to lag immensely. But in Unreal Engine, we can just sculpt around to our liking. But of course, I do not want this right now, so I will click on Modes and choose Select. This is our default mode. If we now click on Play, you can see that our character spawns way in the air, but we can run around on our landscape. Of course, the huge problem right now is that we do not have a texture. In earlier videos, I would texture terrain in Mixer, But this actually is a huge problem for terrain that we want to render in detail, because you have to imagine that we are texturing the whole terrain with an 8K texture. This is why games use tiling textures, because the texture resolution will be much higher. Of course, we do not want just one texture tiled across the entire terrain, and this is where auto terrain materials come into place. Auto terrain materials basically allow you to instantly texture a terrain. And for this video, I am using the one by Unreal Sensei. I linked his video on how he created it in the video description. To import the auto landscape material into our project, we have to firstly open the auto landscape project and then migrate this folder to our personal project. So let's select it, right click and choose migrate. After that, OK, and then select the content folder of our project. Choose select folder and Unreal Engine will notify you if the migration completed successfully. And now we can load back to our own terrain and switch to our saved map. Now, how do we apply this new material to our terrain? Well, basically we just select it and in the newly generated auto landscape folder, under materials, we can just drag and drop the mountain material into the landscape material slot. And you will see that Unreal Engine is quickly compiling all the shaders, but nothing really works. To fix this, we can go into the landscape editing mode to paint and in this material blend layer, select material blend layer info. And just like this, you can see our terrain is textured. Luckily, we are not bound to these preset textures, because I imagined this landscape as an Arctic one. So let's quickly open Quixel Bridge, which you can use for free if you render your scene in Unreal Engine, and choose a simple snow material, click on export, and a rock material, and also export this one to Unreal Engine. Once everything is imported, we can double click on the landscape material to open its properties and just drag and drop our new maps into these parameters. And just like this, you can see that we have a finished mountain terrain, fully procedurally textured and playable. But there are still some issues left. For example, you can see that there are these strange squares on our terrain. To get rid of these, we have to build the lighting. So, under Build, choose Build Lighting Only. This will then take a few minutes, depending on the complexity of your scene. But you can see that now all of these little squares disappeared. And lastly, we of course want to render our terrain, because personally I didn't plan for this to be in a game. But how do we do this? Well, you can see that under cinematics there is a level sequence which we can add. Let's do this and save it. And then this window should pop up. We can use this window to add a new camera into our scene. It is instantly selected and we can move it around. So let's place it to where we like it. For example, I enjoy this perspective. And now we can adjust its focal length, aperture and focus distance. But for now, I will just click on this button, select PNG and set the end frame to 1. This way we do not render a sequence, but just one frame. And now we can click on Capture Movie. And this is the output image in our specified path. The capturing process is extremely fast, because again, this is a real-time engine. If you want to use this terrain in Blender, you can even just select it, go to File, and export selected. Sadly, it doesn't export the textures. And yeah, that's basically it. In this video, I wanted to show you the things that are possible with real-time game engines and that we shouldn't limit ourselves to offline renderers. Hopefully, you learned something and this video has some sort of value to you. If it did, consider liking and subscribing to my channel, and we will see us in the next video next Saturday.